if you play your cards right, you can win this beautiful Pontiac Firebird. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bill Rafferty.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Hello. Once again, I beat my podium to my mark so I wouldn't get hit by it. Welcome, everybody, to Card Shark. Of course, this is the game where you can win $32,000 on the turn of a single card. We've got lots of other exciting prizes. Don't forget about that Pontiac Firebird. I'd like to get started right now by meeting our lovely dealers. Let's bring them on out. Here they come right now. Here comes Susanna Williams and Lacey Pemberton. Sometime in the near future. We're waiting on them at the third.
They wouldn't open the door for you.
They have a mind of their own. They have a mind of their own.
You could have thrown the cards out to me, and I would have set them up.
Turned them over, right.
Okay, let's get started. We're in the middle of a game right now, ladies. Yes. Why don't you deal it out for them, and let's meet our card shark. Come on out, folks. Here's Terry.
What's Bill?
Terry, our returning champion investment broker from Northern California over in my neck of the woods. Interesting question now. You have in your possession $11,098 cash in prizes. That's how much of a champion. You've got some time to let this sit with you. Any ideas what you're going to do with it?
Invest it.
Invest it.
They go invest it, yeah.
But have you thought about it, seriously?
No, it hasn't all sunk in yet, I don't think.
I know.
I'm just glad and excited to have it.
You forgot about your Bahamas trip? I had to remind you about that.
I didn't even know I won it.
Good for you. Well, good luck to you, Terry, and hello to Deborah, your challenger. Good to have you here with us. Deborah is from Australia. She's nice enough to be visiting with us. I asked you this. Do they have this show in Australia?
They don't, but we're going to get it there, Bill.
You're going to get it there, yes, absolutely. What do you do in Australia again? You're a teacher.
I'm a gym teacher in a boys' high school.
In a boys' high school. Well, that must be rough. Well, good luck to you, Deborah.
Thank you.
To both my contestants. You guys have cut your cards backstage. Yep. Good. Let me just remind you, we have got a trip in the cards right now. We've got a trip to Trinidad in the West Indies. That's over $3,000. We've got the refrigerator cash cards. Let's get started right now. This is our second game, third question. Lacey's already set up the cards right now, and this one goes to Deborah. This is a must-win situation for Deborah. We surveyed 100 bachelors, and we asked them, if tomorrow your girlfriend told you you were going to be a father, would you be happy? How many bachelors said they would be happy to learn they were going to be a father?
Well, I think they'd probably be panicked to know that they were going to be a father. So I'm going to say a low number, 25.
You're going 25. Terry, what do you think, sir?
I think a bachelor, not ready for that. Usually you want to be prepared for that type of a thing. So I think it's going to be even lower than that.
You're going lower. Yeah. I think they'd be real happy. I think you could kind of get that 50-yard stare.
That's nice, honey. That's really nice. I like that.
The actual number of bachelors who would be happy to learn they were going to be a father is 36. Well, it's not lower, it is higher. So they would be happy. Deborah, you've got a good card here. What do you want to do?
I'm going to take it higher.
You're going to go higher. She keeps it and goes higher, and she's got an 8.
Okay. Higher.
She's going to go on. She goes on and says, higher than an 8, you've got a jack.
Lower.
Lower than a jack. A 6. what do we do here? She's in a must.
Take it up.
She's going to go. She's going higher. This could tie it up. Higher than a 6. It is. You did it. Very good. Terrific. Deborah did what she had to do. She has tied it up. She has won one game right now. First contestant to win 2 games. They go on to the money cards and all sorts of other goodies. Let's get started right now with our tiebreaker. Susanna and Lacey are setting up the board for that right now. And as usual, with a tiebreaker, 3 cards, maximum of 3 questions. First question goes to Terry. Again, we have the pleasure of welcoming 10 senior citizen ladies over the age of 65. Here they are. Terry, this question's for you, sir. Before the show, we asked these 10 senior citizen women, do you find bald men sexy? How many of these 10 women do find bald men sexy?
I've actually heard it said from women that they find, some women find bald men sexy. So, some women do. I'm going to say it's the middle of the road. 6, I'm
going
to say.
You're going with 6. Deborah, what do you think?
think bald men are sexy, so I'm going to go higher.
You're going to go higher. This is interesting. This is interesting. I saw a twinkle in Deborah's eye. The actual number of these women who find bald men sexy is 2. It is not higher. It is lower. Who are the two ladies who like the guys without the hair? Let me see. Raise your hands. Oh, there's Marion. I knew it. Marion was in there. Marion and Eva. Thank you, ladies. Have a seat. All right. Here we go, Terry.
Okay.
Take a look at your card. Tell me what you want to do.
I want to change that card.
You're going to change that 8. That 8 now becomes a king.
Okay. Nice and low now, Bill. As low as you can go.
Low and the king. He's got luggage.
Some new luggage to take to the Bahamas.
Yes. That's right. He's got a trip to the Bahamas. If he wins the match, he's got some luggage to go with it. Susanna just put it up on his side of the board. He also has $500 up there. Okay, we're going lower than a king, right?
Lower than a king.
Lower
yep.
than a king. He's got an 8.
Oh.
I don't believe it. That is about the, I think that's the third time you have done that.
Yep.
All right, well, we take it down to Deborah now. Deborah gets a free shot at the cards. A must play from this one right here. $500. Cash card goes on your side of the board right now, Deborah.
Thanks.
Let's replace that. You cannot change this card, Deborah. You have to play from it. It is a queen.
Bring it down.
She goes lower than a queen. We've got a 3.
Stay up.
Higher than a queen for the game, the match, and $500. It is. A new champ.
You want to go?
New champ. Well, that good. Terry, there was only one card that could beat you, and you found it.
Yeah.
The third time. However, listen, you've been a wonderful champion. You have got $11,098 cash in prizes. Yeah. Good luck.
Thank you.
See you back
Thank
in Northern
you,
California.
All
Come
right.
on, Deborah. Do you realize that not only have you won the game and the match, you just won $500?
I can't believe it.
You've got $500 in your pocket. When we come back after this commercial message, you could win $32,000 in cash, and there is a caller waiting. We'll be right back. You guys, should I look in the camera? You can look anywhere you want. You can look up there. You can look out there. You're the champ. Seize control of an opportunity when I arrive. Okay, here we are with Deborah. She is our champion, and she's going to go to the money cards, and she knows how to play the money cards. Lacey and Susanna are dealing it out right now. But in addition to all the money this young lady can win, we've added a joker to the deck. Anytime it turns up in the money cards, she's going to have an opportunity of winning that brand-new Pontiac Firebird that's sitting right back over there. Yes, indeed. How are you going to get it back to Australia is the question. But,
I'll come here and drive
it. Golly, listen, stay here and drive it around Sunset. Okay, now, for winning the match, we're going to get you started with an extra joker that Lacey's holding over there, so you're going to be guaranteed at least one chance at the cut. Let's get her started right now, Deborah. We're going to give you $200. You've got it. Let's bet your way to the stars, young lady. Here's your card. Tell me what you want to do. You got a 10. You can change it if you wish.
150 lower.
You're going to go 150 lower than a 10. We've got a 6. 350 on a 6.
50 lower.
You're going to go 50 lower. 50 lower than a 6. She's got a 9. All right, you're saving yourself some money. Don't forget, Deborah, you can change one card per line. You got a 9?
Change the 9.
You want to do?
Change the 9.
You want to change the 9? Pick a card.
From 1.
Okay. Deborah takes card number 1. Hopefully, we'll get a good card on this. It is now a 5. $300 on a 5. $300 on a 5.
200 higher.
200 higher than a 5. It is a 3. Go. I can't believe these cards, how they're turning out. We're not getting the good rolls. Anyway, it's a good news, bad news scenario. You got a good card here. We're going to give you $400 more now, Deborah.
Right.
You got $500 and you're playing off at 3.
All of it higher.
All of it. Woman goes for the gusto. You gotta like it. All of it higher than a 3. Come on. It's there.
Yeah!
$1,000 on a jack. $1,000 on a jack.
200 lower.
200 lower than a jack. A 10. $1,200 on a 10.
I'll change that card.
You want to change it? Which one?
3.
Number 3. Okay. Hopefully we'll get a good card for you. That 10 now becomes a 2.
Oh.
Very good. 1,200 on a 2.
All of it higher.
All of it higher, says our Aussie lass. There it is, a 5. $2,400. You've got a 5. Remember, on this bet, you must wager at least half your dollars.
I'll I'll change it to the two.
You're going
to
change it. Make the decision to change it. Hopefully we'll get us some help. Remember now, you must wager at least $1,200 on this car. It is a seven. Tough call. Tough call. You're going to go. You're going to go. You're going to go $1,200 higher. I hope it's there. I really do. I want to see you make some money. If you're right, you're going to have $3,600. It is. Not bad. Not bad. You know, I was watching you. I got the impression as I watched Deborah, who has just won $4,100, that every time she made a choice, she thought somebody was going to shoot her. She was like looking all over the place. This is not bad. You have more fun to come. When we come back after this commercial, you've got a joker. You're going to want to bring a new car. It's going to get better. We'll be right back. Back, everybody. Now the fun begins. Because Lacey is holding the joker that Deborah is going to use in hopes of winning this brand new car.
A new Pontiac Firebird, the car that's ready to prove its Pontiac performance title whenever you are. The legendary Firebird, only from Pontiac, we build excitement worth over $14,000.
Yeah, all right. Come on up here, Deborah. Let me tell you how you're going to do this. In front of you are seven cards. Behind one of them is the word car. You find it with the joker, and you're going to be driving on the wrong side of the road in Australia. It'll be a lot of fun. Go ahead and find that card. Go ahead. All right. I always ask, any particular reason why you picked five?
I just had a flash.
You had a flash.
I don't know what it was.
All right. Well, if the word car is behind here, you will have a lot of flash to drive around in. Is it here? No. I was hoping. Ooh. You're not going to like this. You know where it was?
Where was it?
It's right here.
Yeah.
Right here. Somebody in the audience won the car. Anyway, that's all we have. Anyway, you've got $4,100.
Thank you.
And you won this champion, and you have to face another challenger. So go on over there. Come on out. Let's meet Mark right now. Hello, Mark.
Hi, Bill. How are you, sir? All right.
Tell us a little something about yourself.
Well, I'm Mark Lowe. I'm from Honolulu, Hawaii, where I graduated in communications from the university there. And I'm Chinese-American, but I think much to the dismay of my family that's out there and my ancestors, I was a Japanese radio announcer.
You're a Japanese radio announcer?
Yes.
You are?
Yes.
Interesting. I want to get to the game now, but I'm going to talk to you a little bit about that as we go on. All right, you've already cut your cards backstage?
Yes, I have.
I just want to remind the contestants again, add prize cards to the deck, and what do we add? A trip to Portugal, over $4,000, close to $5,000. We got a Honda over there, a Honda motorcycle, some real goodies. Okay, now, Lacey's dealt out the cards. That can mean only one thing. Question number one goes to the champion. Here we go, Deborah. We surveyed 100 women who are top business executives, and we asked them, is your job more important to you than your family? How many women executives admitted their job is more important?
I don't believe many of them would. I think family comes first for a lot of women. 12.
You just got 12. You're saying 12. Mark, what do you think, higher or lower?
Well, you know, as I think women are progressing more in the business world and becoming into the higher positions and things, work has to become more important. So I think it's going to be a little bit higher than 12.
Going a little bit higher than 12. All right.
Yeah.
Crowd agree? I'm going to go with Deborah on this one. I think it's just still on the low side of it. The actual number of women executives who said their job is more important than their family is 10. It is not higher. It is lower. It is lower. A lot of women leaving the workforce, as a matter of fact, and going back to the house. All right, Deborah, here's the card. Tell me what you want to do with it. You got a jack.
Bring that down.
He goes lower than a jack, you got a four.
Take it up, thank you.
If he wants to go higher than a four, we got a jack.
Lower.
Lower than a jack, you got a nine.
Lower.
You're going to go for it. If she's right, she's got game number one. Lower than a nine, it is. You were thinking that you weren't going to do it, right?
You were right.
Yeah, I could see that look in your eye. You were very nervous. But you made the right decision, and poor Mark, he got frozen out right there. It was very quick. You've got one game on your side of the board. First contestant to win two games. We know what that one's all about. Mark, this is a must-win situation for you. You've got to get in here if you want to get a shot at the money cards. And Lacey's already dealing out the cards for game number two. Let's get started right now. This question will go to you. And an educated guess, Mark. You've got to think about this a little bit. How many U.S. senators are under the age of 50.
Let's see, U.S. senators, so that would mean there are 100 senators, I believe. And I'm going to say there's three that are under 50.
Three under the age of 50. Deborah, tough question for you coming from Australia, but what do you think?
I've seen a lot of good-looking senators on television here, and they look like they're under 50, a lot of them, so I'm going to go higher than that.
You're going to go higher than that. It's amazing what they notice when they come here. The actual number of U.S. senators who are under 50 is 30. It is higher. It is higher. All right, Deborah, the champ goes back, and we saw what happened the last time. Let's take a look at this face card and see what she does. A 10.
Can I change that card?
You certainly can. If you get the high-low question right, you can change the card. The 10 now becomes a 2.
Okay. Take it higher, please.
Higher than a 2, she says, and there's a queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen, we've got a 4.
Okay, take it higher.
She's going higher than a 4. We've got a trip to Portugal. Ooh. Trip to Portugal goes on her side of the board. What an amazing country America is, ladies and gentlemen. All right, let's replace that. I want to recap so we know what we're doing. You're playing off the 4. What do you say?
We want to go higher.
She wants to go higher than a 4. We've got an 8. Uh-oh. For the game, the match, and the trip to Portugal, a tough call right in the middle. Lower than an 8. No. So, a lot of damage done with that call. We go all the way back to the 2. Mark breathes a sigh of relief.
That's right.
And, Mark, you have to play from this card. Here it is. A 3.
Let's go higher. Baby.
Higher than a 3, he says. We've got an 8.
All right, lower.
Lower than an 8. We've got a 9.
Lower.
He's going on. Lower than a 9. Video camera. Another one of our prize cards comes up. Susanna Kandap put the video camera on Mark's side of the board. Let's replace that. Again,
I'm going lower.
Lower than a 9. It is a 10. So, another trip back to the base cards. When we come back, we will have our second question right after this commercial. We've been waiting here patiently for you to come back. But here you are, and we're about to ask our second question to our champ, Deborah. And this is the fun question, as always, our audience poll question. 10 young ladies over the age of 65 are out there right now. Nice to have them with us this week. Deborah, this question goes to you. Before the show, we asked these 10 senior citizens, do you find people who are older than you more interesting company than people who are younger than you? How many of these 10 women do find people who are older more interesting company?
I have to go on my mother, who finds most younger people more interesting than herself. So I'm going to say that maybe these ladies feel that way, too. It's a low number. It's going to be a 2.
A 2, she says, with self-assurance. What do you think, Mark?
Well, looking at these ladies, they're so charming and beautiful. And I think they'll be entertained of anyone of any age, but I'm going to have to say it's a little bit higher.
Higher than 2. The actual number of these women who find older people more interesting company is 4. It is higher. It is higher. So, which of the 4 ladies who find the older company? There they are right now. Boy, I like that red hat, Mabel. That is a nice hat. All right, thank you very much, ladies. Have a seat. Here we go. Mark, playing from a good card here.
I'm going to keep that card, and I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 3? We've got a 4.
And I'm going to go higher again.
Goes higher than a 4, he says, an 8.
I'm going to have to freeze.
He's going to freeze. It's a must-win situation for Mark. He's got to tie it up and get to that tiebreaker if he wants to be the champ. We'll be back with the rest of that right after this. Welcome back. We're going to have to pick this up tomorrow. I wanted to ask Mark. Mark froze on the 9. On an 8 because of the other scenario. Am I right?
That's right. You learn from past errors.
Yeah, I know. Both of you, as a matter of fact, both of you did the same thing and ended up going all the way back. You had good cards, and then you busted out, and you went all the way back to good base cards. And we're going to have to pick this up tomorrow from where we left off. The thing I wanted to get from you, now, you said you are a Japanese, you work for a Japanese?
I was a Japanese DJ in Hawaii. Right.
How do you introduce Madonna in Japanese?
Oh, let's see, really quickly. では、次の曲は Madonna が
You know what I say, you know what I say, Madonna. Leslie Feminist, Susanna Williams, Gene Wood, Bill Roberts, Yodomo, Tamara Kacha, Yodomo.